Whoops!
Thank you.
Thank you. when he found Dr. Dominic's office, my brave, fearless, and courageous friend didn't hesitate to scare himself to death again. And I'm not surprised. It's not easy to come face to face with a living mummy who doesn't have my charm. She introduced herself as Ramona to her friends. After the shock, Ramona told us that there was no map. She was the one who knew how to find the Emerald Tablet. But she would take us only if we made her famous. It wasn't easy, since Tad couldn't even make himself famous. But we agreed. The conversation was interrupted right at that moment. Pickle and Ramirez showed up again and we were forced to make an escape. Problem, Ramona wanted to take her bathtub. Solution? It was the bathtub that took us straight to the Seine. managed to walk away in one piece and squeaky clean from a bathtub chase. The same can't be said of the bathtub. But the worst thing is that the curse was getting worse. I was transforming more and more frequently. Ramona explained to us that I would become a mythological beast more and more often until it was permanent if we didn't lift the curse. The only way to stop it was to travel to Egypt and open the Great Pyramid, where the Emerald Tablet was kept. But to get inside, Ramona would have to complete the ritual that would crown her pharaoh, which she never managed to finish because her cousin killed her 3 days after she took the throne. So far, so good. If it wasn't for the fact that we were in a sewer in Paris and we had to somehow get to Egypt, which seemed impossible. It was one thing to get a mummy on a plane, another to get an Amit that weighs several tons on one. Until our friend discovered that we had a rubber chicken. And that gave her an idea, because it turns out that I, like Amit, can fly. And I love toys. Who knew we'd find a way to get there that was even stranger than a bathtub? And that it could be controlled by squeaking? The trouble started the second we got close to Egypt. Trouble? Catastrophes! The evil Emerald Tablet was so powerful that it took over the mind of the one who most wanted it, Victoria Moon. And not only that, her power was so great, she opened a wormhole in the Great Pyramid. She sucked us all in to try and make us her slaves. Well, not all of us. Ramona was driven back by some sort of magical force that wouldn't let her in with us. And when the magic hole closed, she became our only hope of ever seeing the light of day again.